Hey guys, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. So today I'm going to discuss one of the most popular supplements for athletes, for building muscle, for strength and stamina, and that's creatine. So make sure you also watch to the end of this video because I'm also going to discuss the number one cause for building muscle and also losing fat, which I assume is the reason most people take creatine and obviously watching this video. Now getting back to the creatine, it's a very old supplement. All right, it's been highly researched, and because of this, it's also misunderstood, and so much of the information about it is just wrong. And this comes from the fact that I actually personally tried it well over 25 years ago, and it was super expensive back then. In fact, I remember it was something like 100 grams, which is about 3 ounces, was like $50. Since then, I've tried multiple versions and variations trying to see what works best, if at all. And I bring this all up because someone asked me recently, they said, "Hey, Dr. Sam, I'm so confused about creatine. First, does it work at all? Is it safe? I've heard that it's bad for the kidneys. Also, which form is the best? I've read that there's so many, the creatine monohydrate, the ethyl ester, the hydrochloride, the buffer, the liquid, the magnesium, so on and so on. You've never steered me wrong. Please give me the 411. Yes, so there are many different forms of creatine, and this is because the supplement companies know that because it's so popular that they keep wanting to sell you something cool or new and better. It's just mainly about making more money. And I hate this because I myself, just like you, am tired of just honestly being ripped off and lied to. Anyways, the bottom line is that the best form and most researched is the original creatine monohydrate. It works the best, it's the safest, and guess what? It's also the least expensive. Now you can get that same amount of 100 grams for about $4 versus the $50 that I used to spend, you know, back in the day. Now, one problem with creatine is that it doesn't dissolve very well and thus doesn't get absorbed fully. So my suggestion is to get the micronized creatine monohydrate. Now, you put it in about 8 to maybe 16 ounces of warmer water to help it dissolve better. And I suggest using about 2.5 grams at a time, half the dose that's recommended, less but more. This also dissolves better. And as far as the total daily use, forget the whole loading phase of 20 grams, you know, for the first week or two. These higher dosages are linked to kidney problems and even kidney damage. It's just safer for you to take about 5 grams to a maximum of 7.5 grams daily. So here's my suggestion. Take about 2.5 grams, which is half the recommended dose, doing about 8 to 16 ounces of warmer water, preferably. But do this 2 to 3 times daily, all right? Spread it out. Now, the best time would be about an hour or two before your workout and also immediately after your workout. Otherwise, just spread it throughout the day 2 to 3 times daily. Again, a 2.5 dose, recommended dose. Now, you might take about 7.5 grams total on your workout days, 5 grams on your non-workout days, and I also suggest you take at least 1 day off every week. This can be another non-workout day. It's always good to take a break off from all the supplements, even if it's just once weekly. Keep in mind that creatine doesn't work for everyone. Some people, you know, it works better like anything else. But I've noticed that those who don't eat red meat, it does work better for them. Vegetarians, I see the most effects, positive effects, as far as the creatine aspect. So there you have it. For creatine, save your money and get the most benefits with the micronized creatine monohydrate. However, if your goal is to gain muscle and strength while losing fat, you must optimize your hormones. I keep saying this in every video. This means increasing your anabolic muscle building hormones such as testosterone while minimizing your negative hormones such as the female and stress hormones. Listen, all the creatine in the world won't do anything if your hormones suck and you have low testosterone. This is just a simple fact about life. And below this video in the description area, I posted a link to a formula that you can use that's guaranteed to optimize your hormones and thus maximize your muscle building, fat burning potential at any age. Thanks for listening and have a happy and healthy day.